coming up next on Real Talk After Dark TV.
Okay, right now we've got the rising star Q all night taking pictures right now. And we're going to turn it back to our energy drink. It's very crowded in here. We're in the actually in the VIP room. Okay, so tell me a little bit more about your
drink.
Yes.
Okay, this is one of the signed DVDs you see me right here with mm-hmm. DJ Frank White.
Mm-hmm.
Me and my man right here, Rashad Bashir, we did something at the Breakfast Park talking about the S6 energy drink. It's crazy. We did a YouTube video called S6 energy drink promo.
Mm-hmm.
Rashad was in Harlem just bugging out talking about our network.
Mm-hmm.
Rashad's an up and coming comedian.
Mm-hmm.
She's here tonight if you saw her doing stand up comedy.
Oh, okay.
Catch him on YouTube, Rashad Bashir. Me, I have a lot of rappers and models. And
what the rappers do, they basically promote your drink?
They freestyle. Like I got this one girl named Pretty Stizzy. She's on YouTube. She did a freestyle from Club Premier earlier this year.
Mm-hmm,
she won an award as one of the top 10 best artists.
Okay.
Then we got Neverless, from a Latino rapper. We did an S6 Interfink promo video from Madison Square Garden.
Mm-hmm,
behind New York Knicks. Check that out. The video is called S6 Interfink promo. It's crazy.
Okay, so you told me you received an award recently.
I got an award certificate from as Explosive Griner.
Mm-hmm.
It's my third straight year nominated.
Mm-hmm.
We'll find out if I win the award next year, okay? I was nominated for my Black Man Can Awards as one of the top businessmen.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't win the award, but I was more or less up and coming up. So I got a DVD coming out called Sean for the Unsung DVD.
Oh, okay.
It's going to be crazy. I have a lot of rappers rapping about the train.
Tell us where they can find your drink at and your advertising.
Catch me on Twitter, Sean Fogler, Facebook, Sean Fogler, YouTube, Sean Fogler, website www.lifestyleblogspot.com. You call me at 1-800-235. I'm here at the Rising Star Awards. I'm here with the lovely Shakira who's interviewing me tonight. I got my sister here, Big Joe. Yo, Big Joe, say hello to the people.
What's going on, man? My name's Joseph.
Hey, Joseph.
I promote an energy drink for Sean. I've been doing this for 3 years now.
Mm-hmm.
I work with him at Radio City, and,
shout out to Radio City MSG. I've been there for years.
Oh, so what y'all do over there?
Well, I'm a security officer, man.
Oh, okay.
I'm a guest server. I smile, take to the seat.
Oh, alright, alright.
We're doing a Christmas show right now. Ho, ho, ho.
Oh, okay,
shout out to the
okay.
Rockets. You
know so what that's what's up.
3 weeks of a Christmas show. No MSG.
So can you show us some of the items you got?
Oh, yeah, we got the six child right here. You know what I'm saying? Six child right here. And these are the lovely models. This is Alexis Richards from South Carolina.
Mm-hmm.
This is the lovely Tana Diosa, Latino model from Chicago. So in the race, creed, and culture, to be an Essex model, you gotta be pretty, very intelligent, sexy,
mm-hmm.
and you gotta get on your grind, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
I had over 20 models that helped me promote Essex energy drink.
Mm-hmm.
We used a towel or old sandwich to make things happen. And right here is one of my rappers that's rapping about the Essex energy drink. His name is Neverless. This is Lazy Mixtape. Never.
Mm-hmm.
He's on K-Sharp TV, and if you are upcoming rapper that can spit freestyles, contact ksharptv.com and get the mm-hmm. other tape of the rapper right here. This is High Yellow rapper Pretty Stizzy.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty Stizzy is on High Yellow Entertainment. I met her at Club Pyramid a year ago for
mm-hmm.
the Elgin's program.
Mm-hmm.
Stizzy did a YouTube video of me rapping about Essex Energy Drink.
Mm-hmm.
It's called Pretty Stizzy Freestyle Essex Sean Fielder. You catch
mm-hmm.
on them a few more videos. This is one of the hottest mixtape title freestyle. You
know what okay.
I mean? And this is the Unsigned Heat DVD. Me and my man Rasha Bashir, who is here tonight, upcoming comedian. We did this video out in Rutgers Park in Harlem. Represent Harlem, shout out to Harlem.
Oh, okay, that's what's up, and that's where we at right now.
That's right, Harlem, of course, you know, Rising Star Awards. And you're gonna see the Sean Felder Unsigned DVD real soon. It's gonna get crazy.
Okay, that's what's up. So you guys got energy towels, you got all this stuff. Do you guys sponsor companies or anything like that?
I've done events from Elegant Hundreds, there's a program. I did a couple fashion shows with Says Man to Feet. I was one of their sponsors. I did a sponsorship event for Mr. Entertainment.
And what you got over there, the EHMP?
Oh, this is one of the awards that was nominated last year for Explosive Grinder. Mm-hmm. I was marketing and promoting SX Energy Drink. I'm nominated for the third year in a row. Shout out to Elegant Hoodies Loser Program. The award nomination is December 21st in Brooklyn. I will be there personally to get my certificate.
Okay.
The award ceremony will be in January. We'll see if I can get that award. So we'll see what happens.
Okay. That's right. Thank you. So what site can you guys be checked out at?
You catch me on Twitter, Sean Felder, Facebook, Sean Felder, YouTube, Sean Felder. Got over 30 videos promoting SX Energy Drink. Mm-hmm. You catch me hopefully soon on Instagram. Contact me to get SX Energy Drink. You go 1-800-235-6500. Mm-hmm. Call me personally at 646-673-1997. Sean Felder, SX.
All right. Thank you, Sean. This is the Suki Suka Real Talk After Dark Radio. And I'd like to thank Sean Felder and his drink special that have been going on for years. And you're still doing your thing.
Yes.
Still doing your thing. And I'm proud of you. Proud to see you.
Yes,
oh,
right,
wow.
Right,
is that for me?
Yeah, that would be for you, baby.
Yes.
And the advice for people, I tell them,
okay.
Never give up. If any haters standing your way, your dream. I don't care if it's your girlfriend, your boyfriend, the best friends. You find out a lot about people when you're down.
That's right.
And when you see they're not in your corner, what you're trying to accomplish and fulfill your dreams, get rid of them. Kick
that's
the
right.
You know what I'm saying?
That's right. You're
yeah,
right.
Shout out to all your haters also.
Okay,
man.
Haters.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Got enough of y'all.
Okay. All right. Okay, thank you.
Every third Wednesday at the mall at Shrine World Music in the Hall. 133rd and 134th at 7th Avenue. And listen, come out and get tested. Move your status.
All right, thank you, Maria Davis. We love you. Brother Cope.
Right, M.E.K.
Uh-huh. So tell me how you feel about this lovely event today.
Well, you know, it's all right. It's much, it let us much more produce better than it was last year.
Okay.
Even though my man got Artist of the Year and we performed, we rocked out.
Oh, okay.
I don't think we're performing today, but you know.
Oh, okay.
I'm getting my little snacks one.
Yes, yes. So that's Tanya Brielle's famous chickens and cooking and everything. Yes. So we're going to go run up on the Tanya Brielle. Hello, Jiggy J. Are you over here trying to eat up all the cake before I get to it?
Yes, I am.
Tanya, don't give him no more because you're not supposed to get my cake. You guys meet the brilliant. She's such a great cook. I mean, all around. It's pastries. Last time we had Hennessy and these. I don't know if they got them in there.
Yes, that's what's here now.
Oh, okay.
You see the wetness? I just sprayed some.
Oh, my goodness, girl.
I have to give you one.
Oh, yes, yes. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. You guys see mine? Chocolate, which I'm not supposed to be having. But, hey, yeah, singer. So, Tanya, tell us about your business. This is your logo right here.
Yes, it's Miss Tanya's Catering, your Simple Delights.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm a personalized chef, and I personalize all events. You just don't come and get the average stuff. You get everything personalized to you. So I actually interview you for what you like, what you don't like.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not about me, it's about you.
Okay, so where can we contact you get these lovely cakes?
Well, you can contact me. I have a website. It's simpledelights.me.
She makes food too, besides cake, food too, and the way she makes it is great. You have a great cocktail hour, I love it.
Thank you.
You know, you're always doing your thing at the Rising Star Magazine, rock out celebrities and everything, so I'm watching you. So, where are you going to be next?
Right now, this is my last thing for this year. I'm closing out, unless somebody hires me, but other than that, I'm kind of taking it easy for the holidays.
Okay.
And you'll see what happens in 2014.
So do you cater parties if they call
whatever,
you?
Whatever you want.
Okay.
You know, don't ever hesitate.
All right.
Think time.
And where are we at right now?
And we're at the Rising Star Workshop.
Okay. Tanya's always supporting them too. That's right. Thank you, Tanya.
You're welcome.
All right.
I might need you for my release party.
Okay.
anything while he's at the album release party?
Well, you already know. We have fun, you know, I'm out here. Most of the entertainment. You already know who you're here to be over. I'm out here. You know what I mean? Yo, Streets, what's up, baby? You know what I'm saying? It's a whole group. I'm out here, you know what I mean? I guess they got me doing the cypher this year or something.
Oh, you're doing the cypher?
No, normally, you know, I keep my mouth shut, you know what I mean? But FLA, stand up. I already know.
Oh, but I didn't see you on the cypher flyer. You must be a special guest.
It is what it is. You already know.
Okay. So can you tell them where we at right now?
Yeah, but right now, you know, we're up in the Rising Star Magazine Award Show. Mm-hmm. Featuring your boy, J.J. the D.O. and all the artists that's out here. You know what I mean? I'm having fun. I'm enjoying it. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Much love.
Is that right? Hello, Mr. BLO.
I know
what's going on. What's going on, BLO? What you doing? You look like you got fat. Is it because you had that
fat
little baby?
Like that.
So did you have a baby or we just clueless? Did you just have a baby?
No, I did not.
You didn't?
I have a new nephew.
Oh, you had a new nephew.
They get fat. We know he's a female friend. We said, oh gosh, how you doing? You got fat.
She looks just like a singer that I know.
Yeah.
A brand new video.
Is that right? And what's that video?
Juicy Bacardi.
Juicy Bacardi, all right.
She looks like a singer I know that had this song called What Is Up.
No, well, up? I'm both of them singers.
I'm Chaz the Entertainer, I'm still alive.
Yes, Chaz the Entertainer is still alive. You know what I'm saying? Mr. VLO, what's going on? I heard you was nominated for an award.
Yeah, I'm nominated for the I Am Hip Hop Award. Blessed, this is my second annual show. This is my second nomination.
Oh, okay. Okay. Well, it's great to see you.
As always.
All right.
Did you get reintroduced to the Chocolate Hennessy Cupcakes?
Oh, yes, I did. Yes, I did. Yes, I did. And I had one of them. But I'm not going to have too much tonight, you know? So, BLO, tell us where we at right now.
Right now, we at the second annual Rising Stars Awards in the Dempsey Theater.
Okay.
At Harlem 127th Street.
Okay.
And we recorded. Can I put in the plug? www.blomusic.tumblr.com.
Okay.
And I got one more.
Yeah.
www.livefromthehood.com. The first, the only monthly showcase series in the North Bronx. Check us
all
out.
All right, that's what's up. All right, BLO, you know where to catch me at.
Yes,
Real Talk After Dark.
We need to catch you at Live from the Hood.
Oh, nah. I'm coming. I'm just working on some new projects, but I'll be back. Hey, Spinderella, what's going on?
How you doing?
I'm Suki Soup with the Real Talk After Dark Radio. Yes. Suki Soup in the house. So, Spinderella, you're the original Spinderella.
Absolutely.
I understand, and I understand you received an award today.
Yes, I did.
And what was it for? Yes.
Star Wars. They surprised me. I was getting an award.
For real? You go, girl. You go. I got one last year. Top Artist of the Year. Yes.
Did you know you were getting your award?
No.
Told you off guard, right?
Yes, yes. Q is great. Mr. Almighty, what would you like to say with Spinderella real quick?
Duchess Spinderella.
Hi, Duchess. What's going on? Yes, and you standing right in, next to the most beautiful person in the world. Yes.
That's how you're
treating. So, Spinderella, tell us what you're doing next and what's going on.
I'm working on movies. I'm working on fashion. I just received the Fashion Icon Award from Sophia Davis.
Mm-hmm.
Classic Gang Family. And so I'm doing my own. I have my own line. I have my lipstick, nail polishes, and things like that. Glass eyewear, accessories, carry bags.
Okay. So where can we check out your fashions at? Like,
the designers are working on everything now. So as soon as it's done, believe me, we're having a big launch party, a whole Cinderella campaign. Mm-hmm. We're gonna have Duchess. We're gonna have everybody.
Okay.
All
right, so what's up, Duchess? What you doing now?
Duchess is living a dream and a nightmare.
Oh, okay.
I'm doing
She's
all
the pain.
Yeah.
Tattoo.
And how do you ladies feel like being about? How do you feel?
We gotta get you in the
Okay, so how y'all feeling about this whole event?
This is a beautiful event. It's wonderful to see all these successful young cats.
Okay.
It's like a bridging of the generational gaps.
Yes, yes.
All the people that came before and people that are doing the talent. That's what we need right now, these generations. We need
yes.
to understand that without them, there would be no us.
That's right. Ladies, I'm gonna come back and beg for a picture, but okay. I'm gonna let y'all do your thing right now. No. All right,
please.
Okay.
Please,
all right.
She's not here tonight. My sister Sheila Mathis, Rich Nice, The Wave Entertainment, PR Sean Breeze, Curtis Morris Jamel, and for everyone here tonight, thank you so much. Appreciate it.
And from Houston, Texas, but he moved to Virginia. He's really doing his thing. He won hands down, for the best R&B artist of the year. I now introduce to you, Kevin Christian Dozier.
Thank you so much, Trina. I appreciate you. Humility, integrity, loyalty, you know, everybody's been on this stage thanking God, and I mean, and of course, I would have to thank him as well, but I want to thank him for allowing me to maintain my humbleness as I continue to grow as an artist, as a publicist, and as a businessman. So, thank you so much.
Sing that shit. I'm teasing up.
Turn up. Turn up. Turn up. Turn up. Turn up.
Turn the beat on.
In the hat, in the rain.
You better not have no bra under that jacket.
We were so dangerously sweet.
She was actually really trying to turn herself around, I must admit. I mean, she was really turning herself around. But, you know how I say when it's too late, and the streets already took her. And even though she was trying to turn herself around, her body said, it's too late. So, one tragic day, I was looking for my sister, and I went to her house, and I was banging on the doors, because she wasn't home. So I went home. So the next day, I went there again, banging on the door. She wasn't home, so I searched around for her boyfriend. I found the boyfriend, and I was like, is she my sister? He was like, nah. I said, okay. Third day, that third day, I got a knock on my door. And it was the police telling me my sister dead now. So, you know, I must have, it affected me a lot because I became more angry with life. I mean, life itself. Because even though I was trying to be there for her as much as I can, it's like I failed. You know? Anyway, I felt so bad, I couldn't even look at my sister's picture. That's how bad it was. I couldn't even look at it right now. My sister wanted to be up here right now, but I couldn't put it up. I couldn't. I would be looking at it now. I ain't want to show that side. So, on the behalf of all that, somebody told me and gave me an idea, maybe I should not let her life and her story, her well-being, die off.
That's right.
You know what I mean? Let everybody know that you gotta be there for your family no matter what.
Yes, sir.
No matter what. How they look, how they smell, whatever. That's your
right.
Family.
That's right.
You gotta be there for your family no matter what. And I was there no matter what. I went in the street and looked for the father and brought her home. My sister was messed up. And I didn't care because that was my sister. I, nobody say.
That's right.
That was my sister, my only sister. So we started this Tara Stanley Foundation for her name to live on and teach people. Not only about AIDS, about AIDS and being there for your family. Even if they do have AIDS. Alright, so we're gonna do what I think is right is bring somebody up who can tell y'all more about that. And that's Maria Davis. Maria Davis, come on.
Hello, everybody.
She can tell y'all about her more than you guys about that situation. But before she talk, we're gonna have Duchess come out. Duchess? This is Duchess off of Black Ink. Come on, Duchess.
Well, Maria is like, to me, she's like my mama away from my mom. And she has her own children, but the amount of children that she really has, I don't think no woman could ever push that many babies out. So I just want to say that if you don't know this woman, you're missing out on like one of the biggest
Amen. Blessings
your life probably could ever have. And the amount of lives that this woman changed, like, first off, let me just, I gotta take a second to tell y'all the story, because nobody knows this story but me and Maria. And y'all seen a show when I tattooed Maria? I went through hell and high water just to get that tattoo done. I met Maria season one. I fought with the network and fought with the network. I begged and pleaded, can I please do this tattoo? Because we have so many young people that come in and get tattoos, and I don't say, are you HIV positive? And they don't tell you if they are. So for someone to come in and to be willing enough to be open with me so that I can protect myself even more, I gotta respect that. And I gotta encourage that, because we gotta have more of that in the community. So I told VH1, like, if you're not gonna do this, then I'm not doing any more tattoos. So if you watch season two, and you see that they got me looking like, excuse my language, a bitch, it's because I literally fought with them for all the things that I believe in. Whether they believed in it or not, didn't matter to me. And I paid a big cost for that. They damaged my image, they tarnished my reputation. But because of people like Maria, I don't care. Amen. Because I get a blessing of this business, anything that we have come to ever do. That's why I do what I do, and that's why I'm so grateful to have this woman in my life. Because that tattoo was nothing. The tattoo was like this much of what we have in store. And that tattoo was this much of what we have in each other. Like, the things that I have invested in this woman are far more greater than just that tattoo, and vice versa. And for that reason alone, like, I can't say nothing, but I thank God for that opportunity. A lot of tattoo artists will be like, I'm not doing it. And I can't be like that because this is... She tried to get in touch with me through Puma, through Sassy. None of them would even give her my phone number. That's how crazy it is. And I went down to Miami, and y'all, I'm sure y'all see me go on stage for King of Diamonds. But little do you know, all of the money that was made from that dance was donated to Maria and her organization. So what I was there for was bigger than me just getting on stage. And I took women from a battle women's shelter out with me that night. And those women got to enjoy a night that they never had before. So the thing that you saw on the media and everything, please y'all, be intelligent consumers. Know what you're watching. Understand what you're watching. Because what it is what they want you to see.
That's right.
And that's all that you'll ever see if that's what your mind allows you to believe. Open your mind and explore things so that you can know for yourself. Because it really is that real. Trust me, I'm living. And you would think that I hate VH1. They make me look like I don't care. Because if you cross me, I will be that bitch on TV. And I will treat you the same way I treated all of them. But if you be kind to me and respect me the same way that I would do for you, you'll get some of the blessings that you'll never, ever understand. And this woman is definitely, definitely a memory that I will never forget and that I will always appreciate for the rest of my life. And the amount of lives that she's touched, y'all just would, your mind can't even fathom it. I've watched it in one day. In one day, I've seen it. And you literally, it's like breathtaking. So, Maria Davis.
We love you, Maria! Yeah.
This is, first of all, I'm gonna tell you, I love Duchess. She is like my daughter. I fight with her every day. Girl, don't let them people change who you are. God has a bigger picture than VH1. God has a bigger picture than Black Amy. And she's always talking about how big she wants to be like me and other people. I said, but you're already like that. Because every time that she steps in front of a young person, she has influenced so many young girls. Every time I see young sisters, they are coming up to her, Miss Duchess, including my niece, who's 10 years old. She's two-faced to my niece. She don't never talk to me, but when she saw that I was with Duchess, she was like, Auntie Maria, I was like, get out of here, girl. And we had a Black Ink party, too, when the session that, 206, episode 206 that I was on, we did a Black Ink party at Aloth. And my 10-year-old niece was at the Black Ink party. She didn't care to come see me. She just wanted to take a picture with Duchess. But I'm gonna tell you, this award, the Tara Stanley Award, although Tara Stanley may not be here, I'm still Tara Stanley too. That's what I want you to know. So I'm an extension of her. So this was my sister. And you know what, life has so many ups and downs and turns, and sometimes our journeys stop with us in all the wrong places. Not knowing who is who, but trying to make who. Not understanding that God loves us more than anybody on this earth. But we don't know that. Because most of us want our love to come from a man. But we have to learn that love comes from ourselves. From God first, who teaches us how to love ourselves. And that's what I want my young sisters to know. All this entertainment, I came out of the music industry. See, that's how I became an activist. See, See, I thought God was lining me up to be Maria Davis, the promoter that was on Jay-Z's album, that knew Queen Latifah and Puffy and Biggie and all these different people. But God was just lining me up so that I can be on this stage to talk about HIV and AIDS. And I got it in the hospital, 95 pounds, with an opportunistic infection. And I said, God, my goodness, it took me to go through all of this for me to find out how great I was. Scarred up face, and I was a model, a fabulous model. I still look good. And let me tell you something, the craziest part, when I got neuropathy in my feet, which is it came from HIV medication, so I have a problem walking. It's from my knees down to my feet. The HIV medications gave me bad circulation. And I remember when the first time I had to get up and walk on a cane and how vain I was. And God said, you know what? I'm gonna have to take you all the way from the bottom. You know how the record goes? You started from the bottom, now you're here? That's how God has to do us sometimes. He has to take us, strip us of everything we know and who we are, so that he can work on us to be who he wants us to be. And I'm gonna tell you, this is, music industry is a beautiful thing, but guess what? The most important thing that you can do in life is touch somebody else. If you do music and that's what you do, write music to touch somebody else. If you a poet and that's what you do, write poetry to touch someone else. Don't just hold your crotch and call girls bees and be disrespectful. Make a change. See, Tara Stanley was also Nelson Mandela too. You may not see her as Nelson Mandela, but she was a part of that movement. Because she's changing lives right now. And Nelson Mandela was in prison for what? 27 years. 27 years he was in prison. But he changed the world. And I just went to Woodburn Correctional Facility on Friday. And I said to all my young men, about 200 of them, if Nelson Mandela can change lives in a prison, what's your excuse? You don't have none. So when you go back to your room, your cell, whatever it is, pick up your sad self, your story, whatever your story may be, you got locked up, whatever, you was in the wrong place at the wrong time, and make something out of it. Write your children, write your nieces, write your nephews, your friends next door, and tell them, don't go down the same road I've been down. Educate yourself. Let me tell you, my young brothers and sisters, go to college. And if you can't go to college, find a technical, something you like to do. And hone your skill. I got my bachelor's degree at 52 years old. I turned 54 on November 13th. And every day that I get up, it's exciting to me. I still have AIDS, but guess what? AIDS don't have me. And AIDS do not define who I am. So I do want to shout out my showcase that I do every Wednesday, every third Wednesday of the month, man, Wednesday. At the Shrine right here in Harlem. So if you're a showcasing artist, please see me. And when you come to Shrine, if you have not been tested, we will test you. We do HIV testing right there in the club with your drink in your hand before or after you do a song. And we do have condoms. And don't ask for magnums, please, if you're not magnum sized. All my children do. Because as I said in Black Ink to Walt, and I said to Duchess, why is everybody a magnum man? Because you know, I'm going to tell you, I'm going to give you a little history. A regular magnum can fit over my whole head. A regular condom, I mean, can fit over my whole head. It is how you put it on So all of this talk about I need king size, I need this and I need that. If you need, if you that big, get a female condom. That's the largest. That's what I'm talking about.
That was a good one. That was a good one.
Where's my kid? Oh, my God. Oh, I'm sorry. I love you. Hold her ears. But I'm going to tell you, educate yourself. Make sure you test it. Don't tell me nothing about you got a husband, your boo, and all that kind of stuff. That's great. But know your status for yourself. And know one thing, I just want to tell people this too. When you test today, and you were not using a condom last night, you gotta get tested again. Because there's a window period. If you test and you come back negative, you have to go back 3 months later and make sure you're negative. Then once you get tested after the 3 months and you deal with that dude, then y'all can talk about a relationship. Relationship is not sex.